Oh my god. Is that my camera? That was interesting. All right, how's it going? I'm really off to one side of the screen today. I'm that ginger photographer. I'm all set up ready for today's video, which is all about food photography with only one light set up. So I've recently changed from the Canon to the Godox flash system. I've got the trigger on and I've got the flash in a softbox here, and I've got some fake background set up as well. This video is going to be all about how you can set up, still laughing that I sat on my camera. This video is going to be mainly about how you can use a really portable setup like this, one light, one softbox, fake backgrounds you don't even really need to take with you if you're shooting on location, and you can set it up in a really cramped space like this, whether it's in a restaurant or whether it's in a kitchen. If you haven't got a lot of room to work with, you can still make this work really well for you. If you've seen my video the other day, you know that I've already tried to make this video, forgot that I was making a video, cooked a burger and just ate it instead of photographed it. So I'm going to go and get another burger now. Hopefully I'll remember not to eat it. I do want to point out that I'm not a high-end food photographer by any means. This isn't the type of photo shoot where you're styling the food for an hour before photographing it. This is the photo shoot where they're paying $175 for the hour and then we'll photograph maybe six dishes in that hour. But this is just the kind of setup that I take with me when a restaurant's maybe changed the menu, the season's changed, the specials have changed, and they've got six or seven new dishes that need photographing. I'll take this setup. It's easy to do, it's quick, it's portable, and it doesn't cost the restaurant a fortune either then. So I'll be right back. I'm gonna go and get some more burgers now for this video. I don't know what to do with this anymore, so I'm obviously gonna be capping that up. So I'll see you when I get back. All right, I'm back. We've got our burger here. I'm not gonna lie, I've just tripped coming up the stairs and dropped it all over the stairs. So we lost some items along the way. So we've got our burger here on a tray ready to photograph. And I'm just gonna go through some different lighting setups and different lighting techniques. So the first thing someone might do when they're setting up food photography like this and they've only got one light is they just think, boom, I'll put it to one side. And all you're gonna get when you do put one light just to one side like that is really harsh side light. Yeah, it looks cool and dramatic, but you kind of lose this side of the photo when you've got this side, because all you're doing is your light's hitting this side of the burger and it's just creating shadows right across here. So the first thing I would do there is just to bring the light forward a little bit like this, just so you're hitting the front end of the burger more than anything. Rather than just trying to hit the side of it, you want to be hitting the front of it as well. I'll be honest, the burger looks great considering it's just fell down the stairs, but but this side is still a little bit dark. So all I would do then is just use anything you've got that's white. I've got this whiteboard that would do the job. I've got this reflector as well. Anything you've got white or light that's large will do the job for what we're gonna do here. All it's gonna do is the flash is gonna light up this side of the burger. And as the flash comes across here to hit this, it'll bounce back off onto this side. Both sides are now lit. It doesn't even have to be a white reflector or anything like that. It can be a white wall. It can be a whiteboard, as I say. You could use a piece of white card or a large piece of white paper. You could get somebody to hold something white, even an open book, this side of the photo. Anything like that that's going to bounce the light will just light it up. If you remember my previous video about shooting with negative space, this is also a great opportunity to do that. You can change the composition and leave a lot of negative space ready for the restaurants or the cafe owners to put their logo into. Or if they're posting any special offers on social media, they can use that empty space to put the text in rather than putting the text over the main bit of the image. They can use that bit of blank space that you've left for them. So something else I think it's worth mentioning is I always start adding in other elements to the photographs as well. So that can be anything depending on what you're photographing. It can be bottles of beer, it can be cutlery, it can be other plates and other dishes. Whatever it is, make sure it goes alongside with that dish and make sure that it helps tell the story. Don't just start adding random things in for the sake of it. And also think carefully about where you place them. You don't want to place something like a beer bottle in front of your light, because that's just going to cast a shadow straight across your food. It's also important not to bunch things up too much as well. You don't want everything crammed to one side or everything crammed behind the burger, for instance, in this picture, because all that's going to do is make the picture look messy and nothing's really going to stand out. What you want to do is you want to kind of look at your composition, maybe place your main item in the middle and place other things off to the side so that it kind of draws you in rather than just piling everything behind hide it. It's not going to make anything stand out. It's not going to make one particular item stand out. So when you're placing things in the picture, give things a little bit of space. Don't worry if the edges are cut off certain things in the picture, because you might cut the top off the beer bottle, or you might cut half the chips off. All the viewer's going to do when they see that is they're going to imagine the rest of the picture. They're going to imagine a lot more's going on. So they might just imagine that the whole scene is a lot bigger purely by you cutting it. If you think of any lay flats you maybe seen of a pizza from above, if they've got other pizzas that are half cut off, you don't just assume that the pizza ends there. You always imagine the rest of the pizza in each corner. So don't worry about cutting things off in your pictures either. I also change my lighting for each dish as well. I'll do some from the side, some from a little bit front on, and then I'll raise it up and shoot down a little bit. And what this does, it lights the dish from above, but it also creates shadows underneath, something like this, like a burger bun. The shadows will be heavy underneath, and the dish will be lit from above, but we've also got that reflector bringing light into the other side of the image as well. I'll also mess with different colours. So I've got the gold reflector on here, and all that's doing is it's adding a bit more warm light to that side of the dish. So as you can see in this picture, the warm reflector is landing on the chips, which is just warming those chips up, and it's warming that side of the bun up as well. And remember, if what you want to achieve is mimicking window light, all you need to do is use a bigger softbox. The bigger that softbox is, it's spreading the light out a lot more, and it's mimicking window natural light a lot more by doing that. It's not as harsh on your product, it's not as harsh on your food, it's spreading it out nice and even, just like a big window would do. I think it's important as well to go through the client's portfolio, through their website, through the social media already before you go at the shoot. The main reason for this is because if they're using really dark images all the way through, you don't want to turn up and just produce really light images unless that's what they've specifically asked for. You need to kind of tie it in with what they're already using. So unless they specifically ask for something different, make sure you're kind of getting the same feel as what they're already producing and what they're already using. And the last thing I'd mention is, don't think you have to use flash for this either. This can be a continuous light if that's all you've got. It can be a lamp. You can do it next to a window and use natural light if you want to. It doesn't have to be a flash with a softbox. It could be a lamp like this if you just wanted to use something like this. Anything that's going to light the food in your favour will do exactly the same job as this flash. So it doesn't always have to be a flash with a softbox. It can be a continuous light. If you do use natural light through a window or outside shooting, just be wary that through the day the light can change, clouds can come across, so you might always be changing your aperture to try and get it to be the same consistency throughout all the pictures. But just don't think you always have to use flash for these pictures. If you don't have any food clients already, you can easily build up a portfolio like I've done, drop your burger down the stairs. Whatever you want to photograph, you can make it home, photograph it, put it on your social media, and someone's probably going to book you off the back of it. I'm going to be posting more content like this one as well, so if you want to subscribe, if you want to catch those videos, they'll be coming up in the next couple of weeks as well. So thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Love you, bye.